The legacy-less former community organizer, Barack Hussein Obama, who just returned from a trip to China where he criticized President Trump for not adhering to the global climate change agenda set forth by globalists, spoke in front of a large crowd in Chicago, the same city where Barack sat, for 20 years, in the pews of a church and listened to his preacher and his self-described mentor spew hate for Americans and whites. In his speech, the man who set racial relations back 40 years, and divided our nation in ways that we haven't seen since the Civil War, stood in front of a crowd of Americans and suggested that President Trump is the equivalent of Adolf Hitler. Obama also took credit for single-handedly wiping out Ebola and expressed his biggest regret of not being able to enact gun control. Miss him yet? Crane's Chicago business, American democracy is fragile, and unless care is taken it could follow the path of Nazi Germany in the 1930s. Mixed in with many softer comments, that was the somewhat jaw-dropping bottom line of Barack Obama last night as, in a Q&A session before the Economic Club of Chicago, the Chicagoan who used to be president dropped a bit of red meat to a hometown crowd that likely is a lot closer to him than the man whose name never was mentioned, President Donald Trump. Obama's comments came after a series of playful questions from moderator and Aerial Investments President Melody Hobson in the great Batman vs. Superman debate. For instance, we learned Obama sides with Batman before she eventually asked him what he's learned as a world citizen of sorts. One thing he's learned is that things don't happen internationally if we don't put our shoulder to the wheel, Obama said, speaking of the U.S. No other country has the experience and bandwidth and ideals. If the U.S. doesn't do it, it's not going to happen. Obama gave one specific example, but it was a solid one. Ebola. To fight the virus, the U.S. did everything from build an airport tarmac in Africa to send in medical teams and ferry medicos from other countries. We probably saved a million lives by doing that, he said. At least indirectly, those comments could be seen as criticism of Trump, whose foreign policy focuses on an America First paradigm that critics say distracts from this country's unique role. Obama moved from that to talking about a nativist mistrust and unease that has swept around the world. He argued that such things as the speed of technical change and the uneven impact of globalization have come too quickly to be absorbed in many cultures, bringing strange new things and people to areas in which people didn't, used to, challenge your assumptions. As a result, nothing feels solid, he said. Sadly, there's something in us that looks for simple answers when we're agitated. Still, the U.S. has survived tough times before and will again, he noted, particularly mentioning the days of communist fighter Joseph McCarthy and former President Richard Nixon. But one reason the country survived is because it had a free press to ask questions, Obama added. Though he has problems with the media just like Trump has had, what I understood was the principle that the free press was vital. The danger is growing complacent, Obama said. We have to tend to this garden of democracy or else things could fall apart quickly. That's what happened in Germany in the 1930s which, despite the democracy of the Weimar Republic and centuries of high-level cultural and scientific achievements, Adolf Hitler rose to dominate, Obama noted. 60 million people died. So, you've got to pay attention and vote. Obama said his greatest regret and disappointment is the failure to enact tighter controls on gun possession.